Goedenavond en welkom op de maandagavond laat bij Match. Min of meer gebruikelijk in deze uitzending een portret van twee internationaal bekende topsporters. Vanavond een fameuze autocoureur en een al even beroemde tennisser. Hier is Sportrades. Deze week een nieuwe aflevering van Sportrades met Emerson Fittipaldi, voormalig wereldkampioen Formule 1, die nog steeds het jetset leven leidt van een eerste klas Formule 1 coureur. En aandacht voor Donald Budge, die 50 jaar geleden als eerste tennisser de Grand Slam won. Miami Beach, Florida. In deze stad woont een levende legende uit de autosport, Emerson Fittipaldi. Tweevoudig wereldkampioen en al 20 jaar actief in de racerij. Hier achter het stuur van een IndyCar.
For me, when I'm sitting in the cockpit of a Grand Prix car or the IndyCar I'm driving now, it's like if I switch off a plug from the wall from the world. I'm by myself, doing what I know how to do better in life, let's drive faster racing cars. And I'm in control of the situation, and I'm enjoying. It's a challenge for me, and it's just a different world. When I put my visor down, and first gear out of the pit, that's it. And it's just a fantastic feeling. And that's the reason I'm still driving. That's the reason I still love racing, because I'm enjoying.
Emerson werkt hard om succesvol te zijn. Voor dag en dauw staat hij op om samen met zijn tweede vrouw Theresa te joggen. Ze wonen samen met hun dochter en Emerson's drie kinderen uit zijn eerste huwelijk in een luxe wijk van Miami.
I'm very much perfectionist. Inside the track and outside the track. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad, because I'm very hard to my family. I want everything to be organized, everything tied. And I give a hard time to people. I think help me a lot in racing. I think help a lot. You have to be perfectionist to succeed in racing. You have to look every detail. Every little thing you can gain can mean a lot by the end of the race. And to achieve maximum performance to yourself and to the car, you have to be perfectionist. And I think I learned that in sport, and that helps a lot in my professional career.
Al op jonge leeftijd was Fittipaldi geobsedeerd door snelheid. Hij groeide op in Sao Paulo in Brazilië in een familie van race-enthousiastelingen. Zijn vader was een autosportjournalist en zijn broer Wilson was een succesvol coureur. Op 21-jarige leeftijd domineerde Emerson de Braziliaanse racerij, maar zijn uiteindelijke doel was om Formule 1 coureur te worden.
I always as a dream, as ambition, as a racing driver. On my mind would be, if one day I could start a Grand Prix, that's it. I would be, my dream would be true. My dream would come true. That would be my biggest achievement. And when I started racing Super V and Formula V, actually, in Brazil, and I won the Brazilian championship after, before that I won the go-kart championship. And then I moved to England to drive Formula Ford. Going to England, to a different country, to Europe, my ambition was one day I hope I can start the Grand Prix.
Binnen twee jaar nadat hij naar Europa was verhuisd, ging zijn droom in vervulling. Hij ging rijden voor het Lotus Team en ontwikkelde zich tot een eerste klas Formule 1 coureur. Met een overwinning in 1972 op Brands Hatch vergaarde Fittipaldi waardevolle punten voor het wereldkampioenschap. Emerson laat zijn vader meedelen in zijn grote successen.
He introduced me to racing. And he was, sometimes he raced as amateur. For sure that motivated me a lot. Plus, some advice he gave to me, like he said, Emerson, if you want to be a racing driver, take serious. It's a sport with a high risk, and you cannot play around. Just do well, serious and proper. I think that was a great advice.
Monza, Italië, 1972. Fittipaldi staat op het punt geschiedenis te schrijven. Door deze race te winnen, werd hij als de jongste coureur in de geschiedenis wereldkampioen in de Formule 1.
I remember well crossing the finish line in Monza and Colin Chapman threw his hat in the air. And I was world champion. It was like a big dream for me. I mean, like I told you before, I was not even thinking on achieving the world championship when I arrived in Europe. I was just expecting one day to start the Grand Prix race. And it was just a fantastic day. I mean, that was my best day in motor racing. It doesn't matter what's going to happen in the future. I mean, no other day is going to replace that.
In de beginjaren 70 waren Formule 1 races behoorlijk gevaarlijk. Vandaag de dag zijn de veiligheidseisen enorm hoog, maar nog steeds staan coureurs bloot aan grote gevaren.
Everybody, we are going to die one day. But there is no way I'm going to sit in a racing car think about death around. The risk on modern life exists to all of us. You can go on a plane, the plane can crash. You can be trapped on the road and with your family, and you can be hit by a truck or your family. I think anybody who takes a high risk in life, in sport or any activity with a high risk, you appreciate much more life, and it's great.
Emerson Fittipaldi werd in 1974 voor de tweede keer wereldkampioen. Hoewel hij enorm succesvol was in Europa, startte hij in Brazilië met zijn broer een eigen Formule 1-team. De samenwerking mislukte volkomen.
I think in life you do mistakes. And sometimes your goals you don't achieve and you have to accept that. And I think we're just, you know, between myself and my brother, we put the Formula 1 team together. I would say too early. We tried too hard to succeed. We didn't succeed because of many different reasons.
Vanaf het begin werd zijn team geplaagd door technische en financiële problemen. Emerson kwam niet eens in de buurt van zijn eerder behaalde succesreeks. Toen hij zich in 1981 terugtrok uit de racerij, was inmiddels ook zijn eerste huwelijk gestrand.
I believe that everybody has a cycle in life. And one period of life you start. Things start going wrong after years, and it seems that everything goes wrong together. And I was on the bottom of the cycle when I met Therese in Brazil. And we started recovering. I started going up from the bottom again and have motivation for life, for everything, enjoying life again. And I said, why not start racing again? And she helped me a lot. And that was a very tough period of my life. I had to fight to succeed and to recover. And I'm a very optimistic person. Even going through a very tough period of my professional life, my private life, I fight to be back in business again. And I'm very pleased. And I think from the bad experience I have, I learned a lot. I'm much more strong now. I'm much more successful now than I was.
Emerson vierde zijn comeback in de autosport in 1984 als een IndyCar-coureur. Hij raakte snel gewend aan de snelle ovale circuits in Amerika en ook privé raakte hij snel ingeburgerd.
Just by coincidence, I came to America. One of the Indy teams invited me to try Indianapolis. Indianapolis is always in the back of my mind. It could be a dream that the Grand Prix driver wants to experience Indianapolis one day. And I did experience, I love it. I'm here so far into now driving the Marlboro car. I'm really enjoying it. I think the limit is the edge of achieving or not achieving. If you go in a corner, the corner speed, maximum, the ideal corner speed, that's the limit for you and your car is about 125 miles per hour. And if you drive 100.7, you can crash. And if you drive 100.3, you're not going to win the race. You're going to be second or third. And to achieve that edge all the time during the race, to be consistent on that edge, I think that's what makes the winner by the end of the race.
Emerson's nieuwe doel is om kampioen te worden in de IndyCar-competitie. Maar hij heeft ook zakelijke belangen. Hij heeft een citrusfarm, verkoopt sportkleding in Brazilië en handelt ook nog in auto-onderdelen.
To achieve maximum performance yourself into the car, you have to be perfectionist. And I think I learned that in sport, and that helps a lot in my professional career, on my business. With the business I have and people that work with me, they have to be perfectionists, and they are, and that's the team of people I have around me, same as in racing. I think to achieve the balance between my professional life and my private life is very difficult to achieve a good balance. One of the things I'm enjoying in America driving the cars is I can achieve that balance much better than I could in Grand Prix racing. I think is it true that who is in the cockpit enjoying himself driving fast, the race car is having a great time. That's myself. The family suffers a lot. The risk of the sport, the time the sport takes me away from home. The pressure is a constant pressure.
Emerson reist meer dan de helft van het jaar. Maar als hij thuis is, dan krijgt zijn familie alle aandacht.
I like to be what he's going to do next year. I want to be successful next year. I'm talking to you now, and in 2 days I'm driving my new Marlboro car for next season. And that's great. I'm working next year now.